Hello students, in this video I have explained the computer network practical based on understanding the impact of simple hub based CSMA CD network. So before going to show on the demonstration of the practical, I'm explaining just the theoretical base of what is CSMA CD. So CSMA CD stands for the carrier sense multiple axis collision detection. So with collision detection being as extension of the CSMA protocol, this creates a procedure that regulates how communication must take place in a network with a shared transmission medium. So carrier sense is nothing but detection makes sure that all network participants check whether the medium is currently free. Only then does the practical protocol initiate the data transmission. So multiple access is nothing but several participants share a transmission medium, and collision detection means the collision detection is an extension of the original protocol and the regulates how to proceed in case data packets happen to collide. So how this process of CSMA CD works? So CSMA CD is divided into several steps. CSMA CD is a very similar process. Like first the station monitors the transmission medium. As long as this is occupied, the monitoring will continue. Only when the medium is free and for a certain time will the station send a data packet. Meanwhile, the transmitter continues to monitor the transmission medium to see if it is detects any data collision. If no other participant tries to send its data via the medium, by end of transmission and no collision occurs, then transmission has been success. So now look this network setup, which is created by using the end devices. That is, end devices use the desktop machine. Total taken the 6 desktop machine here, and another network device that is nothing but hub. So making the connection between them by using the automatic connection cable. Assign every PC as a desktop IP configuration 192.168.10.1 and subnet mask 255.255.255.0. Same for second machine, its address is 10.2. For third, its address is 10.3. For fourth, its address is 10.4. For fourth machine, its address is 10.5. And for fifth, its address is 10.6. So now see, when station means computer wants to communicate with each other, then he will check, or they will check first, transmission is free or not, means medium of the transmission is free or not, and they will continue monitor the transmission. And if it is, after monitoring, he will use the continue for transmission medium, and participant successfully tries to send the data. So let us see, start the simulation mode, selects ICMP ARP protocol, then take PDU and set for PC5 to PC3. So capture forward start. So PC5 send the data to hub. Then hub can circulate this data to all the devices, because hub is one of the only devices in a computer network. It will send the data which is came from the source. It will be distributed all the connected machine in that network, but the particular destination machine can receive the data properly. And after receiving the data, the destination can send re-acknowledgement. Again, hub can send the re-acknowledgement to all the stations those are connected in a network, but particular source is only receive that acknowledgement, and transmission is successful. But however, so this is the successful transmission of this PC5 and PC3. But if the transmission medium is not free, and at that time more than two machines want to communicate with each other, then collision is detected and the participant immediately interrupts the transmission and instead sends an interference signal, means jam signal, so that all other station can also detect the collision. So now the participant waits for a random amount of time before trying to transmission again. So what is a collision? So collision is occurred station simultaneously check whether the transmitted signal is identical to that transmission media or not. If it is not the case, another station carries out a transmission simultaneously and falses the signal on the bus. Collisions like these occur regularly and are part of the normal operation of a local area network. However, the size of network also increases the probability of collisions. In this case, size refers not only to number of participants but also the length of transmission path. But collision can happen at that time data packet will be lost, means the loss of data is happen. So collision domain is area of network in which participants have a transmission medium and it received via the CSMA CD procedures. So how collision is detected? So let us see the demonstration. Again, I want to set the PDO from PC5 to PC3, means PC5 want to communicate with the PC3, and at the same time PC4 is want to communicate with the PC5. So check it, capture forward, both are transmitting its packets to hub, but hub can make the collision because he will send that data to all the machines, so all the stations can get collide and the data will be lost. So how collision will be prevented? So collision will be avoided with hub duplex system. They are scheduled alerts, and CSMACD ensures that collision do not lead to problems during transmission. However, this only applies to data loss. So to do this, the network must be split switches or bridges. So both work on basic of media access control, works on the second layer of OSI. So rather than we need to focus, rather than using the hub duplex system, we need to use the full duplex, because hub duplex only allows the transmission in one direction, but full duplex, however, station can send and receive at a time. So therefore, carrier sends multiple access with collision detection is not required in networks that uses the full duplex, and collision cannot occurs. So rather than using the hub duplex, we need to use the full duplex on the CSMACD procedure. The fact only one transmission is possible with full duplex, but in hub duplex, but in full duplex we can transmitting and receiving the data in a both side. So rather than using the hub device in the second network demonstration, again same 6 PCs are taken here, but rather than using the switch device and again setting the IP addresses for all these 6 machines, IP configuration here taken 11.1 subnet mask 255.255.0, then it is 11.2, then this machine is 11.3, subnet mask is same having all the machines, this is 11.4, it is 11.5 and this is 11.6. So again here start the simulation mode, same protocol is taken, ARP and ICMP, and set the PDU from PC5 is want to communicate with PC3, and at the same time PC4 want to communicate PC5. So both are transmitting the packets to switch can receive the packets from PC5 to 4. Then switch can send the packet received from PC5 to PC3 and packets received from PC4 to directly PC5. Then again PC3 send the acknowledgement to PC5 and PC5 send the acknowledgement to PC4. Now see, then PC5 send the acknowledgement to PC4 and PC3 send the acknowledgement. So using the full duplex here we can avoid the collision detection occurred, because full duplex at a time we can transmit and receive happen in both directions. So the network can be divided into the bridge of switches rather than using the hub. Thank you.